Well, Mr. Speaker, Chris Neal is a chartered accountant employing five people in St. John. He fears the Liberals' proposed tax plans could hurt his small business and has called the Liberal rhetoric on this highly insulting. Chris is not alone. Over 50 small businesses in New Brunswick have joined a coalition opposed to the Liberal tax plan. Supporters of the coalition include the Liberal MPs for St. John Rothesay and Acadie-Bathurst. If the Prime Minister won't listen to small businesses in New Brunswick, will he at least listen to the members of his own caucus and stop this Liberal tax grab?
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary. Mr. Speaker, as I said, we will always stand behind our small and medium-sized businesses. That's why we're keeping their tax rate the lowest in the G7 so that we can encourage them to continue creating economic growth in Canada. We know how important they are. But there are inequalities built into our current tax system that allow certain of the wealthiest Canadians to use incorporation to have access to tax advantages that most Canadians of the middle class do not have access to. That's what we want to solve, and that's why we've put forward this consultation and these proposals. We're listening to Canadians so we can do things right.
Chilliwack-Hope.
Well, Mr. Speaker, when they stand behind those small businesses, they put a knife in their back. Yeah. In Newfoundland and Labrador, Dorothy Keating, chair of the St. John's Board of Trade, said her members were extremely disappointed after meeting with the finance minister. She likened the Liberal tax plan to building a leaky boat and promising to fix it only after putting it in the water. Will it take a full mutiny of his own caucus for the Prime Minister to realize his plans to raise taxes on small business just won't float?
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary. What the Honourable colleague mentioned is not only fallacious, because we're not increasing the tax rate for small businesses. They're going to stay the lowest in the G7. We're helping our small businesses. But what we want to solve, Mr. Speaker, is simply to target tax inequalities. That's what we're targeting, and that's why we've put forward proposals, and we're consulting so that we'll do things right.